Spherical mirrors. We know a plane mirror, a mirror with a plane surface. Then what is a spherical mirror? Before we see that, if you have not subscribed to our channel, please subscribe and click the bell icon to get all the latest updates. If the reflective surface of the mirror is spherical, it is a spherical mirror. Let us understand few interesting things about the spherical mirrors with the help of this spoon. First, let us observe its surface that is bulged out. The outer surface is reflective and it acts like a convex mirror. What is a convex mirror? If the reflective surface of the spherical mirror is curved outwards, it is called a convex mirror. Examples of convex mirrors are vehicles' rearview mirrors, security mirrors, and dentist mirrors. Now come to the inner surface of the spoon. The inner surface of the spoon acts like a concave mirror. What is a concave mirror? If the reflective surface of the spherical mirror is curved inwards, it is called a concave mirror. Examples of concave mirrors are automobile headlights, solar cookers, shaving mirrors, etc. To understand the working of these spherical mirrors, we need to know the meaning of certain terms. First term, pole. What is a pole? The center of the reflecting surface of a spherical mirror is a point called the pole. It lies on the surface of the mirror. Pole is denoted by the letter P, center of curvature. The reflecting surface of a spherical mirror forms a part of a sphere. This sphere has a center. This point is called the center of curvature of the spherical mirror. It is represented by the letter C. The center of curvature of a convex mirror lies behind it. However, it lies in front of the mirror in case of a concave mirror. Radius of curvature. The radius of the sphere of which the reflecting surface of a spherical mirror forms a part is called the radius of curvature of the mirror. It is represented by the letter R. Principal axis. An imaginary straight line passing through the pole and the center of curvature of a spherical mirror is called the principal axis. We should remember that principal axis is normal to the mirror at its pole. It means that at the point of pole, the angle between the mirror and principal axis is 90 degrees. Principal focus. If number of light rays parallel to the principal axis are falling on a concave mirror, they all meet or intersect at a point on the principal axis of the mirror. This point is called the principal focus of the concave mirror. In case of a convex mirror, the reflected rays appear to come from a point on the principal axis. This point is called the principal focus of the convex mirror. The principal focus is represented by the letter F, focal length. The distance between the pole and the principal focus of a spherical mirror is called the focal length. It is represented by the letter F. Aperture. The diameter of the reflecting surface of spherical mirror is called its aperture. In this lesson, we discuss about the spherical mirrors whose aperture is much smaller than its radius of curvature. There is a relationship between the radius of curvature R and focal length F of a spherical mirror. For spherical mirrors with small apertures, the radius of curvature is found to be equal to twice the focal length. We write it as R equal to 2F. This implies that the principal focus of a spherical mirror lies midway between the pole and center of curvature. In this video, we have learnt about spherical mirrors. In the next video, we will see the images formed by the spherical mirrors. Thanks for watching. If you like the video, please give us a like, please post your comments and share this video to your friends.